Hi. Well, I'm here at my brother's house at sunset in the Inland Empire, somewhere in Riverside County, Southern California. Now, I'm making this video log because my friend and our friend, most of you who will see this will know who I mean, Frank, raised the point of what is a real vlogger or not. And it is, by now, in 2021, this question is almost 15 years old. And actually, if you go back into video art history before that, it's even older. Nam June Paik, a Korean video artist, made what I was told was the first video log in a taxi in New York City with his old Sony camera. But that was a long time ago. Most of us didn't get into vlogging until 2005, 2006, when suddenly it exploded and we could make videos and put them up on YouTube. Yes. Some of people you know, you were on, what was it called? Oh, damn, my memory's failing me. Live video or something like that. Most of the people I personally know, we were on Vlogger Heads. And now I'm with Frank on Vloasis. Although I still look at Vlogger Heads now and then. And I also check in occasionally with the group on YouTube. No, the group is on Facebook. It's called YouTube Old Timers or something or another. But frankly, YouTube is fucked. It's sold out to advertisement. I can't even watch a YouTube video without seeing an ad every fucking 5 seconds. Well, I exaggerate. But just the same. And some of the really great vloggers, like the ones my brother and my son watch, because I've been living here with them since I had my heat stroke attack last summer in August. But I'm about to leave. I'll be moving on in a few weeks, actually. Time's come now. I've had both my shots. See, there's my... This is my baked potato with cheese and hot sauce. And here is my tequila with lemon. Anyway, I decided I would make a vlog without editing it. Because Frank brought up a point which remains very true. The difference between a pure, unedited video log and an edited video log. And then over here is filmmaking, which is completely separate. I do a lot of mashes and filmmaking and smashing and crashing and crashing, which really are not vlogs. They're not even logs. But in the few years, let's see, it's 2021 now, and I started making video logs around 2005, and I started posting my little bits of filmmaking back then around 2005. So that's 15 years. Now, I studied filmmaking when I was very young, when I was 18 and 19, and I realized it was too expensive for me. I wanted to be alone. I wanted to write by myself and make things by myself, and that's where vlogging is perfect. But vlogging didn't come around until many years later. When I was studying film and acting and theater at UCLA in 1968 and 1969, everybody thought that a real artist would buy himself or buy herself a 16 millimeter film camera. Well, that's a long time ago now. We use video now. We have for the last, damn it. I went back to school in the 1980s and I studied video and film, and también estudiaba español porque me gusta hablar español. Tú sabes, yo soy el Tijuana gringo, pues. So I studied Spanish and literature and writing and video and filmmaking from 1983 to 1988. And I almost graduated, but I failed a class in, believe it or not, Spanish. So then I went back to school 5 years later in 1990. Was it 5 years? No, it was more like 6 years later. In 1996, I went back for a year, but I didn't get my degree then either. So I've been to the University of California for 9 years with no degree. Talk about self-destructive failures. Because that is what I am. And I make the camera come in real close to confess my deepest secrets to you. Oh, this is a video log, and I am confessing the truth. Oh, fuck you. This is bullshit. Anyhow, I'm talking about film and video and what it is to make video and what is a video log. I'm not going to edit this. I don't care how freaking long it is. My late sister-in-law used to say freaking instead of fucking. But I don't care how fucking long this video log is. I'm not going to edit it because this is going to be a pure, true vlog. I think I'll have some more of my potato. Yes. Now, of course, I prepared all these things before I turned on the camera. But that's okay. Just as it's okay if some people make notes and follow their notes when they make their vlogs. But the real definition of a pure, unedited video log versus an edited video log, which I have made many, is, do you turn the camera on once and then don't turn it off until you're done? That's my name, Dan. I should have said done, but I'm not going to correct that either. I'm out here in my brother's backyard, and it's my nephew's backyard too. And it belongs to the three dogs and five cats, except we don't let the cats out anymore because the neighbors over there trapped one of the cats yesterday, and we had to rescue it from their trap and take the cat to the vet. And, well, that's another story altogether, which I won't bore you with. although it's probably less boring than my story. My cat's home now. He's in the house, in there. In the bedroom. No, I'm sorry, he's in the master bathroom. With a cone around his neck. I'm looking at the neighbor's house. They've had parties there. I hope they didn't get the coronavirus. I got my second shot yesterday, right here in this arm. Let's see if you can see it. Well, anyway, it's there. I can feel it. Tell me about it. I was lucky. Just a little bit of pain at this injection site. Now, my right arm, that's where I had my flu injection back in October. And it still hurts. Every now and then I feel a twinge of pain. So I had both the plague inoculations. What's the word? Vaccination. I had both my plague vaccinations in my left arm. And wouldn't you know it, my right arm started feeling sore. Talk about psychological bitching. I have fucking been hallucinating that my right arm hurts because I got a shot in the left arm. Well, I have no idea how long this has been. Let's see now. It says I have 12 minutes left of memory. Well, we're going to have to go pretty quick then. Anyhow, I wanted to have this moment with you as a true video log. So many of you have been very important to me for almost 10 years now. Of course, there's William T., who's holding down the moderating fort over at Vloggerheads. And then there's the triumvirate of Silly Silly Tom and God, I'm getting old, my tongue is tied. Marcel. And oh, who is that beautiful woman who says she's from the Virgin Islands or somewhere? Oh, fuck, I forgot her name. Anyway, those three hold down Vloggerheads, but William is the moderator. And over there at Vloggerheads are all kinds of people that I truly admire. Silly Tom. Oh, I said his name already, didn't I? And of course, the polar bear, who I... I believe I was so stupid as to lose her as a friend. Anyway, I'm not going to talk about Vloggerheads anymore because it's painful. Oh, I remember who I wanted to mention. River Vlogger, Ken, who is one of my favorite vloggers. And then, of course, Big Rab. Oh, yeah, I'm starting to think of you all now. But just know that you're special and you are video loggers, and I'm thinking of you here this evening as the night grows darker and darker and I only have a few minutes left. But however long it takes, this will be a real video log of me just talking here. It's been quite a time for all of us. Oh, I remembered somebody else. Cynthia. Oh, yes. And Suja. Oh, yes. And Bonnie. There's so many of you, I can never think of all of you. Never. Oh, and then there's Pip. Oh, yeah. And then there's the one who died, and the other one who died. I mean, Zen, and I mean Dave. They were both very important to Vloggerheads. You know, my last true love, a woman, was named Maria Teresa Salazar Tovar, and I met her in Tijuana in 2000, and we started hanging out together in the spring of 2000, and we went together hanging out and going to places. We even lived together for about a year and a half in 2004 and 2005, but it didn't work out, I'm sorry to say, because she was, oh God, I miss her so much. She died in 2015. And her brother just died 2 days ago on the 31st of March. Tere, or Teresa, had one sister and two brothers. There were four of them. Pablo, Osvaldo, Berta, and Tere. And now there's only Osvaldo left. But all of them, except for Terry, all three of them had children and grandchildren. And my dearly beloved Maria Teresa, Terry used to go back to Texas to be with them every Christmas. Once I went with, well, I went by myself, actually, but I met her there for the 15-year-old birthday party. You know, in Mexico they have, and in Chicano, in Texas and New Mexico and California, they have this thing called the 15-year-olds. Quinceañera. Quinceañera. And in 2003, I went to Laredo and went to the quinceañera of Terry's nieces in Nuevo Laredo. And that was when I knew I loved Terry. When I saw Maria Teresa, she had left Tijuana the year before and gone back to live in Texas, and in Tamaulipas, Nuevo Laredo. She had a house there. She had a house there that she owned. And when I went to see her, when I saw her for the first time, when we met the evening, the day after, no, it was the same day I arrived. I arrived before dawn in San Antonio, Texas, and I took the bus to Laredo, and I crossed over, and that evening I saw her. And when I saw her, my heart literally leapt into my throat, and I felt such a rush of energy flowing through my body, and I knew that I loved that woman. May she rest in peace. I call her the last one, the ultimate, la última, because, well, I'm 70 years old. I don't think I'm going to have another true love. I've had a few through my life, including the mother of my son. My son was born in 1980, 41 years ago. This month of April, he was born 41 years ago. And his wife is pregnant. Yes. I'm going to be, God willing, or if you atheists prefer, nature willing, I'm going to be a grandfather, probably in October. And I want to drink to that. I'm going to be a grandfather. Some of you know what that means. And others of you know what it means to be a parent. And others will just have to imagine what it means. Do you hear the dogs barking? Yes. I wish I could show you the first star. I can see it already tonight. It's up there. Let's see. It's up there. Right about there. No, I can't get the camera to show, or at least I can't see it in the view screen. Maybe you can see it, but I can't. There it is. Yes. Starlight, star bright. First star I see tonight. I wish I may, I wish I might have this wish. I wish tonight that my grandchild may have a good, long life.